140.32分32秒，动物拐航秒。140.32分32秒，动物拐航秒。
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to China Showtime. On January 9, 2023, the government of Djibouti signed a memorandum of understanding with two Chinese companies, Hong Kong Aerospace Technology Group and Touch Road International Holdings Group, to develop and build an international commercial spaceport in the ABIC region of Djibouti. Djibouti is located in the Horn of Africa, near Somalia, Eritrea, and Ethiopia. The project will cost an estimated $1 billion and cover at least 10 square kilometers. The spaceport will feature 7 satellite launch pads and 3 rocket test sites, with a projected completion time of 5 years. The facility will be involved in electronic manufacturing services and aerospace businesses, including satellite manufacturing, satellite communications, satellite control, and satellite launches. Satellite manufacturing is a complex process that involves multiple supply chains and international trade, which is why Hong Kong's tariff advantages are so crucial for this project. The Chinese companies will also contribute to infrastructure construction, including building a port and a high-speed highway in northern ABIC. This project will be jointly managed by Djibouti and the Chinese companies for 30 years. If successful, this project will represent a new milestone in the cooperation between China and Africa in the field of aeronautics, as well as being the first large-scale aeronautical launch base in Africa. This means that Africa's satellites will no longer have to rely on launch platforms from other continents. For China, Djibouti is closer to the equator than most of China's territories and has more favorable launch conditions, effectively relieving the pressure on China's launch base. If the spaceport is built, China's overseas aerospace measurement ships will also have an overseas supply base, which will also help China's aerospace launch missions. Djibouti President Ismail Omar Gayle excitedly posted on social media saying, "I am proud to announce a prior technology partnership agreement with Hong Kong Aerospace Technology Group for the design and operation of satellite and rocket launch pads in Djibouti. This project will cost $1 billion and will last 5 years." In history, Western countries have established several rocket launching sites in Africa. In 1948, the French military established a site in Algeria, where they launched their first space monkey, but the launch site was closed in 1967. From 1977 to 1978, Germany attempted to establish a rocket launching site in Zaire, but it was closed for political reasons. African countries also made efforts to establish a rocket launching site by their own means. Egypt had a rocket launch plan and established a site, but it was closed after multiple attempts. From 1989 to 1992, South Africa established an experimental rocket launching site in Overberg, but it was only a rocket launch testing site and never actually launched any rockets. Since humans first entered the space age in 1957, African countries have lagged behind other regions in space exploration due to their underdeveloped economy. As of the end of 2022, a total of 52 satellites from African countries are in space, representing about 1% of all human-made satellites. None of these satellites were launched in Africa. These 52 satellites belong to 13 African countries, with a significant number coming from Egypt, South Africa, Algeria, and Nigeria. 6 of the 52 African satellites were built and launched with the help of China. Back in May 2007, China launched NixomSat-1, Nigeria's and Africa's first geostationary orbit satellite, and followed it up with a second one of the same model in 2011. China continued to support African countries' journey into space, launching Algeria's first communication satellite in December 2017, and Sudan's first satellite, SUSAT-1, in November 2019. Ethiopia also received help from China to launch their first remote sensing satellite in December 2019, and a second of the same model was launched in December 2020 by China's Long March 8 rocket from Wenchang Space Launch Site. China has also assisted other African countries in building and launching five other satellites through other nations. As space technology continues to advance, the value of Africa's space economy is also growing. According to the Space in Africa report of 2022, the value of Africa's space economy was $19.49 billion in 2021 and is estimated to increase by 16.16% to reach $22.64 billion by 2026. Most of Africa's space economy revenue is generated from fixed satellite services, mobile satellite services, and satellite TV services. Satellites are also becoming increasingly crucial in remote sensing, communication, and disaster management. Many African nations hope to advance their space programs in the next 5 years. Over 20 African countries, including Djibouti, have plans in place, and the African space economy is expected to continue growing. However, Africa currently lacks the capability to manufacture satellite components, and all of their satellites are launched on other continents. The Djibouti Spaceport project, if successful, could change that. It would give African nations the opportunity to launch satellites within their own borders, boosting the demand for locally made components, and helping to develop supporting industries. Africa could eventually become self-sufficient in satellite production. China and Africa have a strong relationship in the aeronautics field, working together through bilateral agreements in the China-Africa Cooperation Forum. The China-Africa Cooperation Forum 2021 Action Plan has outlined plans for the African Union and the China National Space Administration to write a China-Africa Space Cooperation White Paper, further solidifying their collaboration. This spaceport project is a significant new partnership in the field of China-Africa aerospace. Many people are curious about why the commercial spaceport was built in Djibouti. Djibouti is a small country in Africa, with a small population of 957,000 in 2022. And most of its citizens residing in the city of Djibouti. However, its location is quite favorable. It sits at the crossroads between the Red Sea and the Gulf of Aden, near the well-known Mandeb Strait and across from Yemen, which is only about 30 kilometers away. These favorable social, natural, and international conditions make Djibouti an ideal location for a spaceport. Djibouti is an ideal location for a commercial spaceport for several reasons. Firstly, its political and social environment are stable, with a low rate of crime and no anti-government armed forces. Secondly, the location of Abyei region near the 12th degree north latitude is closer to the equator than the southernmost part of China's Wenchang Launch Center, making it more favorable for saving fuel during rocket launches, increasing launch speed, and reducing the correction fuel when launching Earth's synchronous orbit satellites. Thirdly, Djibouti's territory has a tropical grassland climate, with arid and semi-arid areas and less precipitation, making it easier to observe aerospace launches. Lastly, and most importantly, China and Djibouti have a strong economic relationship. Chinese enterprises have invested in various projects, such as the Djibouti Port and Chemical Industrial Park, and have also built the Djibouti section of the Addis Djibouti Railway. The Dohali Multipurpose Port, built by Chinese enterprises in 2017, is the most advanced in the region. and facilitates transportation and the supply of materials. Touch Road International Holdings Group is a participant in the Spaceport project and has established a special economic zone in Djibouti, serving as a prime example of Chinese private enterprises participating in China-Africa economic cooperation. It's worth noting the strong relationship between China and Djibouti, which is exemplified by the presence of the Chinese Comprehensive Protection Base. In 2017, China established this base in Djibouti to provide support for the Chinese Navy's escort missions in the Gulf of Aden and peacekeeping efforts in Africa. The Spaceport project is located across the Gulf of Tadjoura from this comprehensive protection base. The international community has been facing a lot of disturbance in recent years, which have resulted in security threats to China's overseas interests. While the Spaceport project is purely a commercial venture, there are still a lot of uncertainties and risks involved, especially in the sensitive space launch industry. Safety is of utmost importance. The comprehensive protection base in Djibouti serves as a deterrent against any potential forces that might try to harm China's overseas interests. In reality, the cooperation between China and Africa has brought tangible benefits to both sides and has contributed to the long-term growth of African nations. If the Djibouti Commercial Spaceport Project can proceed smoothly, it will lay the foundation for the African aerospace industry. Regardless, the successful implementation of the Spaceport Project will be a significant milestone in the collaboration between China and Africa in the aerospace sector. And as the Belt and Road Initiative progresses, China aims to enhance partnerships with countries along the route, including those in Africa, for mutual advantage and a win-win outcome.